Hi, I'd like to tell you about translations in mathematics. In mathematics, translations come up in many different contexts, but they all have the same flavor. A translation, if you're thinking in terms of a picture, can be just as simple as taking your picture, picking it up and shifting it, then putting it back down. So here's an application or an example of using a translation in mathematics, that being the translation of a function. So suppose that I'm asked to graph a specific function. Here I have y equals x minus 2 squared plus 3. Because of the square, we know that this will basically be a parabola shape. And so I'll start off with that graph first, our basic parabola, y equals x squared. And that's shown here in white. Once I know the basic shape, it's just a matter of taking the different components of the translation and moving the graph around. So notice that the 2 is inside the square, and we're subtracting. So that's going to be a horizontal translation, and it's kind of the opposite of what you would normally think. We normally think that subtraction makes things go left, but when we're talking about translations, a horizontal translation is sort of backwards. So instead of going left, we're going to go right too. So if we consider the vertex of the original parabola, it's 0, 0. Moving it to the right 2 would move it to 2, 0. And then the plus 3 on the outside tells us that we're going to move the graph upwards 3 units. So then we would take our vertex, move it to the right 2 for the horizontal translation, and because the plus 3 is on the outside, we would move the graph up 3 units for the vertical translation. This would put our final vertex at 2, 3, and we can draw the same shape graph that we had previously, and that will be the final graph that we're looking for.